Hello everyone, I'm Yicheng from Shanghai Jiao Tong University. This talk will introduce our work gVulkan Scalable GPU Porting for Pixel Granted Rendering in Ray Tracing. We all know that the world is colorful and the computer prints these colorful scenarios through the rendering technology. The main technology are divided into two categories, rasterization and ray tracing. Rasterization can offer decent images in a low cost, which has been the common method for the past few decades. But now, people are more and more seeking for high quality, high realistic image, which ray tracing can give. Ray tracing can create incredible realistic light effects because it works by using the reversibility of ray passes. It shoots multiple rays from the camera to the screen, interacting with the scene to get the true colors. However, due to the large number of calculations required, ray tracing technologies have traditionally only been used in offline scenarios, such as filmmaking and product design. With the advent of RT-Core in 2018, real-time ray tracing become a possibility. As game and engine continue to support the ray tracing, and scenes such as XR are paying extra attention to immersive experience, real-time ray tracing has become a new trade. However, there are still many bottlenecks to using the ray tracing on the large scale. First, there are still some limitations for users who want to use the ray tracing. Ray tracing is supported by newer hardware. At the same time, it's going to be expensive to use the best ray tracing capabilities all the time. Secondly, even with the help of the hardware, ray tracing still has a higher latency than rasterization. With the official provide code for rasterization and ray tracing to draw simplest triangles, their latency is 6.7 times difference, and the application officially provided by the NVIDIA that does both the ray tracing and rasterization has a 1.5 times performance difference between them. If we need a higher resolution or a higher samples rate to get a clear and more realistic image, the latency required will only be higher. So ray tracing workloads are huge, and how to solve it. The most straightforward method is to reduce the workload. However, reduce the number of samples per pixel increases the noise and reduce the number of bounces take away from the realism of the image. Of course, there are a lot of optimizations for ray tracing nowadays, like super resolution, video interpolation, which use in NVIDIA's DLSS technologies. However, they all produce fake images that will change the truest colors. Another method is to increase the number of GPUs working together to reduce the rendering time. This has been studied a lot in rasterization, where AFR renders one frame per GPU. This approach is easier to implement, but bring no optimization to latency. SFR lets all GPUs render the same frame, therefore it is necessary to split the workload. In this respect, rasterization has solutions for splitting the screen called sort first, splitting the triangles called sort last, and so on. Well, sort last is better in rasterization scenarios, but in ray tracing scenarios, it makes more sense to split the workload by screen. By the way, why we choose Vulkan as our API? Vulkan is the next generation rendering API introduced by Kronos to replace the OpenGL. Vulkan is the lower level API that allow for fine-grained control of the GPU's resources. We found that the GPU can get better performance than OpenGL, OpenGL ES. Also, it has better supported for ray tracing. And compared to the DirectX, Vulkan is an open source API, which is more convenient to use in different OS environment. And now we still have challenges in achieving ray tracing with multi-GPUs without compromising the quality of the image. We categorize them into three parts: ecosystem capabilities, intra-GPU, and inter-GPU. First, there is the ecosystem capability issue. We have a Vulkan ray tracing application that need to run with multi-GPUs. This require modify the original code. Modify an application that was originally run on a single GPU into multi-GPU application takes a lot of effort, so it's not easy to use. Also, if we don't change anything, even if you have a lot of GPUs, none of the other GPUs will be involved in the computation because the application doesn't assign the workload to them. Secondly, there is a lot then that can be improved with intra-GPUs. In a multi-GPU ray tracing application, we can divide its workloads into five phases: pre-process, render, copy, send back, and present. And these five phases together are one frame. And then each frame repeated these phases over and over again in the order. The render and the present phases are handled by the GPU, and while the propose, copy, and send back phases are handled by the CPU. The workloads handled by different hardware need to wait for each other, which led to the waste of the resources. In addition, the present phases is necessary on the local side, but the cloud rendering need to send the image back to the local side through the network. So the present phase is not necessary, which also leads to a certain waste of resources. Thirdly, inter-GPU also has a lot of room for improvement. When we have multi-GPUs working together, there will be rendering and copy text on the GPU side, where the primary GPU doesn't need to be involved in the copy text. When GPU 2 is doing tasks slowly due to other tasks at the same time, GPU 2's rendering time become longer, and all the tasks have to wait until GPU 2's copy task is finished. Next frame can be rendered. Obviously, if there is no way to deal with this sudden situation, the total latency of rendering will increase significantly due to the partial GPUs. Okay, therefore we propose gVulkan, a transparent multi-GPU acceleration rendering solution for Vulkan-based ray tracing rendering. The original ray tracing application could not utilize the GPU pool even in an environment with multi-GPUs. With the addition of our gVulkan, we don't need to modify the application layer code or modify the hardware drivers. We can then make the original application able to use the computer powers of all the multi-GPUs. The goal of our gVulkan is to address the challenges I mentioned above. For ecosystem capability, we address it through API forwarding virtualization method. Virtualization is necessary in order not to modify the application code. At the same time, cloud rendering allow ray tracing to be enjoyed by users with limited environmental devices. For intra-GPU, we need to decouple GPU and CPU tasks and redesign the rendering framework workflows. For inter-GPU, we solve the uneven distribution problem by dynamic workloads self-balance. To summarize, we want to enable cloud-based code conversion from single GPU to multi-GPU rendering task locally without modified native Vulkan applications. And this is the article of gVulkan. It is composed of four main models: transparent resource pool, GPU resource customizer, random manager, and media engine. First, there is a ray tracing application running on the local side, while there is a pool of the GPUs and a pool of CPUs in the cloud. And the transparent resource pool is responsible for intercepting the Vulkan API and then offloading the workload to run in the cloud. The GPU resource customizer manages a resource, divides GPU workloads across GPUs based on GPU numbers, and guarantees logical code flow. When the render manager finds the multi-GPU tasks are unevenly loaded, it adjusts the task allocation method to make optimal use of all GPU resources. Finally, media engine is responsible for merging all the images generated by the GPUs and send them to the original windows on the local side for display. gVulkan presents three important methods to solving the challenges. First, gVulkan proposes a resource classified transparent forwarding. gVulkan first intercepts all Vulkan APIs through the Vulkan layer and prepare to send them to the cloud. However, if all API are handled the same way and each GPU send them and wait them to return, it would be very time consuming. Therefore, gVulkan categorizes Vulkan APIs into three types. For context type APIs, there is no need to modify any parameter and they can be executed in the cloud directly. For handle type API, there is a one-to-one handle between the local and the cloud, which need to be mapped once to run directly in the cloud. Both APIs do not require real-time interactions, so they can be batched processed. The requirement type API is the most special. Its execution result will affect the correct direction of the local code, so it needs to return the result immediately. Therefore, when the requirement type API is executed, the context type and the handle type in the buffer will be sent to the cloud and executed sequentially. And the result returned to the pointer will be returned. In this way, gVulkan minimizes the time consumed in sending the API and in the cloud. Secondly, gVulkan proposes dependency decoupled parallel rendering to address the challenge of intra-GPU. As mentioned above, the presenter phase is not necessary for cloud rendering, so we skip the related APIs when we encounter them in order to speed up the overall rendering. Furthermore, GPU and CPU tasks have the problem of waiting for each other. We decoupled them so that non-dependent tasks can run earlier. The achieving that one of the GPU or CPU is always working all the time. At the last, gVulkan proposed latency determining adaptive load balancing to address the challenge of inter-GPU. When there is a GPU that works longer than the other GPUs, gVulkan will calculate the workload of this GPU based on the amount of current tasks and the time to do the task. And based on the efficiency, it will calculate the workload that is more suitable for each GPU. At the same time, this workload also needs to consider the least copy worker of the primary GPU when calculating, which can allow the primary GPU to do more rendering to achieve higher performance extraction. Okay, and now in evaluation, we will expand on three challenges. And the first, we compare the FPS at different network latency. And gVulkan FPS is 10.3 times higher compared to the scheme without categorization of the Vulkan API. We also compare the difference between the images transmitted back and those generated locally, which have a PSNR higher than 30, indicating that the gVulkan can improve the rendering rate while maintaining image quality. We also compare the latency with different number of GPUs, different optimization schemes, and different resolutions. We found that the inter-GPU optimization has a significant effect, and the GPU and the gVulkan is scalable for the certain number of GPUs. Also, higher resolution has an impact on rendering pressure. At last, we also compare the effect of dynamic self-balance when GPU computing power is changed. We find that dynamic self-balance can bring significant performance improvement when GPU computing power is uneven. At the same time, the stable unit in it can reduce performance loss and performance fluctuation. And other performance of gVulkan can see in the paper. In conclusion, gVulkan is the first transparent multi-GPU acceleration render solution for a Vulkan-based ray tracing rendering. And it presents three methods and achieve 3.81 times speedup at four GPUs. That's all. Thank you.